And I did not expect to be the first comic to end his set with Praise the Lord. But hey. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the stage from here in Knoxville via Nashville, Riley Fox.
Oh, another round of applause for all the comics you've seen tonight. Mr. Matt Ward, host of the band. My name is Riley Fox. I like that name. It's a good name, you know? It's a solid name. Rolls off the tongue. See, I consider myself lucky to have such a cool-sounding name. You know, I feel bad for people who don't. There was a guy running for governor here in Tennessee about a year ago. Maybe you remember his name. Zach Womp. Remember that guy? Zach Womp?
Hell yeah.
Let me ask you something. Didn't his name sound like noises from the 60s Batman show to you? You know what I mean? Like, hey, my man, look, there's some liberals trying to further the progressive agenda. Pow! Blank! Zach! Womp! Oh my god! You just saved Tennessee from the Democrats. Way to go, Zach! Oh, it's nice to be here in Knoxville, Tennessee. Although, like, I lived here for a little while, and I noticed that your city has a little bit of an ego problem. I don't know what the deal is. Like, as long as you guys talking to each other recently, they were friends. One of them turns the other and goes, yeah, that's how we do things down in Las Vegas. How are you going to compare Knoxville, Tennessee to Las Vegas, Nevada, you know? How does that work? It's like, what happens in Las Vegas stays in Vegas, right? What happens in Knox, Vegas doesn't fucking matter. Just have fun, you know? Yeah. So I'm a college student. Any other college students here tonight? Yeah, so I'm a college student, and you know what I hate the most about college? Other fucking college students. Fuck you people. Seriously. If you're in college, go fuck yourself, alright? You know what I hate about college students? They misuse hyperbole in conversations. Most annoying thing I've ever heard in my life. I was recently walking around campus real late at night by myself, and I pass by this girl. She's on her cell phone, she's talking to her friend, and as she walks by me, she like trips over her foot, and she stumbles, and she regains her grounding, and she goes back to her phone, and she goes, oh my god, the craziest thing just happened to me. I just tripped over my own foot. Is that not the craziest thing that could have... No, that is not the craziest thing that could have... The craziest thing that could have happened would have been if she had tripped over her own foot and fallen mouth first on my dick. That! Like, first of all, why would I be walking around late at night with my dick hanging out? That's kind of weird. I can't really break the ice with that. Oh, it's a nice breeze we have here tonight. With me. Good. I am in college. I'm an English major. Thank you. It's the same reaction my parents gave me. Just blank stares, like... Good luck with that, boy, all right? We chose jobs, you know? It's tough being an English major, man. People always judge you, they make fun of you. One time this guy goes, why are you studying English, boy? You talking it. You're not. Professor, seriously? I'm an English major, and I'm a stand-up comedian. So basically what I'm trying to say is, can I borrow $20? Just spending gas money home, situation's dire. Tell you who I hate, though. Philosophy majors. Fuck those people. Because here's the thing, like the only reason I can really hate on philosophy is because, as an English major, those are the only group of people I feel financially superior to. You understand? That's it, man. Bottom of the food chain, you know? And I like being condescending to them because that's the only time in my life I get to feel like a Republican. You understand? That's it. I mean, what's every day in the life of a philosophy major really? It's this. I'm broke. But why? Right, I'm a philosophy major, that's why. Oh man, there's There's a lot of people I don't like at the college campuses. The people that I hate the most are the street preachers. They stand on the corners, they try to talk to you about religion, which is fine, don't get me wrong, but I mean, honestly, the logic they use sometimes just backfires right in their face. I mean, let's be honest, if I'm on my way to a physics exam, I'll see how a guy who walks on water is going to be much help, all right? It doesn't work out. But it's really like, one time I was leaving class, and this guy stops and he's like, excuse me, sir, can I talk to you?
Sure.
My name is Matthew, I'm a representative of the International Association of Krishna Consciousness. I want to give you a gift. And he reaches into his bag, he pulls out this ancient Hindu text, and he gives it to me, and he goes, this book was Buddha's all-time favorite religious text. And then he goes, and it also inspired songs by George Harrison of the Beatles. Now look, I like the Beatles as much as anybody else, but that can't be your number two guy, you understand? Like, he goes straight from Buddha to George Harrison. What is that, you know? It's like if the guy handed me a Bible and said, this book was written by the hand of the Lord God Almighty and also inspired songs by Queen. Creed, you know what I'm saying? I'm on board. Let's do this shit. They rock. I don't know a lot about religion, man. I was with a friend of mine recently. Saw a Jewish guy wearing one of those hats, the yarmulkes. But it was on the very back of his head. Like, not on the top, not on the corner, but on the very back of his head. I turned to my friend. I was like, how does he keep that hat on the back of his hand? Like, is that just God's hand just holding it there? Like, hey, little buddy, I got you, man. You're my little buddy. Yeah. Yeah. I don't know why God talks like that, but yeah! My friend's like, no, Riley, he's got a bobby pin in the back. That's how it stays there. Oh, well, sounds like somebody doesn't have faith. We need to find Jesus. I don't know, man. I'm tired of organized religion. Honestly, I think it's run its course. You know what I'd like to see? Unorganized religion. I think that'd be pretty fucking interesting, you know? Like the preacher's up there and he's giving his sermon like, and then Jesus said, I am Tyler Durden. Oh shit, I'm sorry, this might come in a fight club. Ah, oh, fuck, damn it. I return this. Where is my Eucharist? I always lose that thing, son of a bitch. Oh yeah, it's fun, man. I've been doing comedy for a little while. It's been maybe 3 years. And when you're doing comedy, you always have to play like a lot of really like shit gigs, you know, because that's how you get better. And that's why I want to tell you guys a story about the weirdest show I've ever played in my life. You guys want to hear this story?
Oh yeah!
Damn right you do. About a year ago, I performed at the Are You Funny Like Cat Williams Amateur Urban Comedy Show. Put on by the University of Tennessee Black Cultural Center.
There we go.
Which means that I, Riley Fox, performed in front of about, 100-150 black people at the Are You Funny Like Cat Williams Amateur Urban Comedy Show. I love that name, too. Are you funny like Cat Williams? Spoiler alert, nope. Not at all, it turns out. I found out about the show because my roommate had saw like an ad for it on Facebook, and he sent it to me. That means my roommate saw this ad for this show and said, hey, you know it'd be good for this show. A guy with 8 Rush band t-shirts. Yeah. That'd be a perfect damn fit, send. I'm not putting the show down, it's a fun show to do, but like, and they made a big production out of it. Like the night before the show, I got a call from the organizers like, hey Riley, just want you to know, we're gonna give all the comedians their own intro music when they walk out on stage. So what song do you want? Look, I knew I was dealing with, all right? I knew that the odds of a black guy having anything by Rush were astronomical, all right? And honestly, I didn't care. I was like, you know what, just play the whitest thing you have, you know, just go to your iTunes, your Pandora, put in white people music, which brings up the Counting Crows station, by the way, but that's beside the point. Just come up with the whitest thing, I don't care, it's fine. Motherfucker plays Beyond the Get Jiggy With It by Will Smith. That's not actually true. That's a lie. The real story is that I got played on stage to a song by a rapper by the name of Waka Flocka Flame. Yeah. That's a real name. Was that a rapper or a Pokemon? I don't fucking know. And it wasn't even just a regular Waka Flocka Flame song. No, it was like a dubstep remix. So it was like, wop, wop, wop. Raping Optimus Prime, you understand? that was the weirdest show. Alright, I gotta wrap that up on this. Alright. I love Knoxville. There's a lot of weird things here. You know the weirdest thing I've ever seen here? It's technically not here, it's in Pigeon Forge. It's the Titanic Hotel. You guys seen that thing? Yeah. They've rebuilt a replica of the Titanic. They've made it into like a hotel, a sort of guest resort kind of thing. I think that's a terrible idea. Because that's basically taking a historical tragedy and turning it into a tourist attraction. It's like, what's next? The Oklahoma City bombing firework emporium? Or the Hurricane Katrina indoor wave pool? Go-kart motorcade? Or the Columbine High School laser tag ring.